flashlight on there.
Hi, I'm Britt. This is my good friend KJ. Over on the shelf, we put a flashlight over there. And if you just turn the head just a little bit, you'll turn the flashlight on.
The flashlight just came on.
Okay, can you turn it off for us now? Go ahead and turn it off. Just turn it the other way. Just a little bit. Thank you very much.
Wow.
Well, KJ and I were investigating the reception area. We decided to do the flashlight experiment. It started to work for us. Ask a question, it would come on. Ask it to turn it off, it would turn it off.
Did you work here?
And then we all had personal experiences, so I'm really hoping that that was documented on our equipment here and we'll be able to figure some of the stuff out.
Didn't you guys have that door closed in room 20?
Moved.
Client has had happen to themselves.
Absolutely, and you're going to do the ETC, and that's what was in that room.
Yeah, no problem, for sure.
And you'll take the DVR?
Yeah, and some audio.
Yeah, some audio, absolutely.
Okay.
All right, let's get to this.
Cool.
The ETC unit documents the environment for us in multiple ways. We have a UV camera, we have a thermal camera, and we have an IR camera. So we cover a wide spectrum of light that the human eye can't see. Paranormal activity, when it happens, normally affects the environment somehow, and this unit is sensitive enough to pick up very small fluctuations in the environment.
Are you tired of writing with a pencil when you should be writing with a pen?
What happens when I use a pen?
Tired of overpaying for your high-speed internet?
This internet is expensive. That's tiring to me.
Tired of your wife's cooking?
This is burnt.
La 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 la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la
la Quinta.
And Britt Griffith, director and investigator of the Atlantic Paranormal Society's West Coast organization.
When I look at these cakes, I want to see what's going on. I want to see the ghost. I want to see the particular building where the activity happened in. And I want to feel their emotion through their cake.
In the stone pathway, then it's even all a little bit confusing.
Confusion in the paranormal is normal.
Right.
But in this aspect, I'm like, what's going on here?
Coming up.
Carter, my job here was basically to take the story you put in front of me and then look at your cake and see if you told it. I don't see a seance. I look at your cake and I see the bed spinning and I see the footsteps going up and I think, might have been a bad night at the bar. However, your cake is beautiful. I love the candles. I actually thought they were real flames from a distance till I wasn't.
This place is a very depressing, intense kind of haunt. The people that came here basically came here to die. It was shut down in the early 90s due to mistreatment of patients. So the paranormal activity here is quite high, full body apparitions, disembodied voices, footsteps, things moving, people being grabbed. It runs the gamut. The Wolf Manor has turned out to be a paranormal paradise.
Okay, wait.